have a smile on my face, guys, because we're talking about contracts. Contract, guys. What is a contract? For you, what's a contract? For me, it's the money. I'll be a little strict twice on that one. For me, the contracts are the money. That's where the profit is. Contracts are the reason why you have a truck, trailer, machine, that yellow machine, why you at work. Without a contract, you won't work. Without a contract, there is no money for you. Without a contract, your truck can sit there forever until you get a contract. But mostly, a lot of people don't understand that contracts are the lifeblood of their company. They have to look after all their contracts with care. They have to look after those contracts and respect them. They have to handle those contracts with care for the survival of their business. Look, guys, there are different contracts with different specifications. Plenty of people go into different contracts. Some are by the mines, some are by the containers, some carry medication, some carry vegetables, grapes, milk, you name it. Some actually create contracts for themselves. Those are the real guys that I love, the ones that create their own contracts. You also, if you can, create your own contract. If you don't have it, go out there and look for it. But to be honest, guys, there are different forms of contracts. There are different forms of contracts. Main contract and sub. Main and sub. Which one will you go for? Will you go for the main one or will you go for the sub one? Most people actually get subcontracts, but believe me, if you can, just go for the main contract, because the main gives you the power and the ability to take control of your destiny, while the sub, if you are a subcontractor, which means there is the main contractor who gets all the money first. He gets all the money first, and then he pays you. Some of them, the main contractors, are always late to pay the sub, and this, at the end of the day, the subcontractors fail. They fail because of the main contractors. So if it's possible, just go for the what? For the main contract. Always try and fight to get the main contract. If you're gonna be a subcontractor, then look for one guy that everyone is always talking about. If you, he's the main contractor and you subcontract under him, you hear from referrals that this guy can pay you your money in time, then you can work with that guy. Don't just get a guy who is the main contractor and you're a subcontractor, you don't know how he's paying the other guys that work with him. Then at the end of the day, you'll be here. You will fail, your truck will park, there's no money for you, there's no RRs, runs for you, guys. So guys, they always go for the main one. And the most crucial part is, for subcontractors, most of them don't go into an agreement with the main contractor. They don't sign anything. They just get in there, just sign that I'm bringing my truck, you'll be paying me 100 or what, 100,000, 200,000. There's no solid agreement. If I were you guys out there who are still starting, I'll get a lawyer involved. I'll get a lawyer involved. Involve a lawyer. Involve a lawyer. You pay him some money, but it's worth it. You'll be on your extra eye. Don't sign a fine contract. Don't sign a fine contract. Get your lawyer involved. Let him be your eyes, so that in the future you have less problems. Subcontractors, I want to tell you again, make sure you sign contracts and involve your lawyer. If that main contractor doesn't want to involve a lawyer, it's a red flag. Never work with that guy. It's a red flag. Main contractors, the time has come for new guys who come into this industry who understand what to do and how to catch you. You won't be catching them, you'll be working with them, because education is the key to success. Most people say education won't put money in your account. Yes, it won't put money in your account, but armed with it, you can understand and absolve and know what you need to do. So contracts, it's not a hard thing, just get it, but do it right. There are plenty of contracts out there. You won't sit without a lot, you won't sit without a contract. For cross-border guys, your situation is a difficult one, because you just get jobs each and every time and they pay you half money before you leave, and they pay you once you deliver. Your story is different, but for guys who are by the mines and all that, your story is an easy one, because usually you get a 5 to 10 year contract depending with the guy that you're working with. So guys, make sure you get lawyers involved and make sure you aim to be a main contractor, not a subcontractor. Make sure you tune in to the next episode where we get even more deeper, we jab that thing and enjoy it.